Right, so we're out here in Jungle Mania, and I'm here with Kenny Ken. Kenny, you are the original Jungle Sound Clash champion.
Oh yeah.
I've got one question to ask you.
What's that?
Have you still got the belt?
Oh, of course I got the belt. Come on now, T-Bone man. Of course I got the belt. No one ain't getting that belt from me.
What was the secret to winning?
The secret to winning was selection. That was the secret. Instead of mixing, trying to mix the tunes and trying to do fancy mixes, I didn't mix. If you listen to it, you'll see that I didn't mix. All I done was pure, just draw tune after tune, like a sound clash.
Are you going to draw any of them dubs tonight?
I played already, but I did draw one.
What one was that?
The last tune I played.
Okay, right. You've got a label. I know you had Mix and Blend. Do you have another one? You have still a Mix and Blend. Have you got anything new coming in the pipeline?
Yeah, we just mastered Lala Bella VIP featuring the Ragga Twins and a drumstep version. Oh, thank you, baby. A drumstep version of Murder You.
Right. Obviously, we're here and there's plenty of vibes out there. What do you think makes jungle music so great and it differs to other music?
See, a lot of people get confused with jungle, you know what I mean? Some people think that jungle is just drum and bass with ragga samples in it. But it's not about that. Jungle is a vibe, you know what I mean? And like, you know, there's drum and bass, but you can separate the two if you want to, you know what I mean? And like, but jungle, you know when a man's playing jungle and you know when a man's playing drum and bass. If you're into this thing like I'm into it, then you can tell the difference. But to some people it's all the same, but to me it ain't. Jungle has got a completely different vibe. Because there's more vocals, there's more soul, there's more, you know, there's more of, how can I say it, man? A lot of the drum and bass, what the kids are listening to, no disrespect, but it's a lot of it is just noise to me. You know what I mean? Some of it's good, but I can't play that. I have to play stuff that's got soul and has got feeling, and I like to see the girls whining their batty and, you know what I mean? Things like that, you know?
Now, obviously, you're one of the pioneers and you've been here from the beginning. Can you give me a couple of your favourite jungle memories?
Favourite, sorry?
Jungle memories, memories from jungle, from the jungle
venues. Obviously, venues. The number one is Paradise Club.
Okay, not venues, that's good, venues. Memories.
Oh, memories.
Yeah.
Shit.
Remember when we went to Switzerland, remember this kid was going to beat us up?
Yeah, we went to Switzerland one day, me Det and Frost.
Jumping Jack Frost.
Me Det and Frost went to Switzerland and the security thought they could have us over. But we nearly had them over, didn't we, D? Right? We showed them that we weren't no punks, you know what I mean? So, but like, you know, I'm not a violent person. Don't get me wrong, I'm not violent at all. But, you know, the promoter tried to run away with our money and thing, and I got a bit upset. And security tried to put their hand on me, and I had to show them that can't run, you know what I mean? That's one of my memories with me, Det and Frost. And Det and Frost had my back as well, so that was good. The best one, obviously, is winning the Sound Clash.
Of course.
ring the bell. Can you give me five of your top jungle tracks?
Right, the first one has got to be D Living Y. The second one, from back in the day I'm talking about, not up front, back in the day, has got to be Intelligent Woman by DJ Rap. The third one I would say is what I really liked as well was Let's Go. I forget the proper title of it. Potential Bad Boy. Right? And obviously Jungleistic Man by Conga Natty, Rebel MC. Here Comes the Drums by Doc Scott. There's loads, man. I could stand here all day. You know, there's loads, you know what I mean?
And finally, this is for me personally. Obviously, you know, I've done garage and stuff like that, and I came back on the scene. And this little kid, well, I said young man, hit me up online telling me he's little Chrissy. how do you feel to be a father and a father figure to one of the new, well, I'd say new emerging, one of the top DJs out there?
A lot of people say, I'm glad you got me on camera now, right? Because a lot of people say that it's down to me why he's where he is, right? Trust me. All I've done was planted a seed. That's all I've done. All the rest is all down to him, right? I've not got involved in anything he's doing. He's done it all off his own back. Obviously, you know, like getting work, I've helped him out a bit that way back in the day, early. But like, you know, apart from that, everything he's doing now is down to him. You know, he's a deck destroyer, basically. You know what I mean? Simple.